Hi guys, it's Claire. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about my to-be-read list for August and September because I feel like if I were to try to do a list for 1 month, it would be two books. And even then, what I'm about to present, it's just not that many because I am not a fast reader. I've actually been looking into how to increase the speed of my reading and things along those lines, which, you know, everything just points down to read more. It's like, I already read. I read every day. I'm just not a fast reader. That's just not a gift I have. So it takes me a hot minute to get through a book most of the time. I like these kind of videos because it somewhat forces me to be a little bit accountable and to have a plan for what I want to read, to have an end goal in mind, because maybe that will help me read faster and get through books faster, and to be a little ambitious with it. So I have six books maybe, if I'm including September now that I think about it. So if you like these kind of book-oriented videos, make sure to give this a thumbs up and to subscribe, and let's get started. If you follow me on Instagram, which is Miss Claire Bear with three S's in Miss, then I already put up a photo for my TBR list for the month of August. And it's true, but I'm changing it around because that was before I had this big book haul. That's obviously going to influence what I want to read, but it doesn't change the fact that I am currently in the midst of reading The Blade Itself by Joe Abercrombie, and I'm already super into this book. I love it. I'm about 200 pages into it. It's an odd mix of brutal, not slow, but quiet. So you get that sense of like dread and that it's amping up to something bigger, and there's already been some explosive scenes. It's just not one of those books that's in your face about it right away, but it also has extremely memorable and interesting characters and is very darkly funny. Like I don't want to say laughed out loud, but kind of chuckled to myself, but it's always been very, very, very dark, which I like, and it has that tone throughout the entire book. There's also, I definitely want to do a review about this book, so I'm kind of holding back some of my feelings, so I just want to jump into like certain characters and certain plot elements, but I will get there. I am like very much focused on finishing, so, you know, get there when we get there. My current audiobook is, I mean, what my current audio read has been for the last 2 months, and that is the fourth book in the Throne of Glass series by Sarah J. Maas. I'm about halfway through that book, so I'm also going to include the fifth book. I know the book I'm on is Crown of Midnight. I think Crown of Midnight or Queen of Shadows. They're getting all jumbled in my head, but I'm on the fourth one, which I really, really, really like right now. If you've seen my review about the second and third book in that series, which I don't blame you if you don't wanna watch because the video quality is so terrible, so sorry about that. I talk about how like I really, really, really didn't like the second book, but I really liked the third one, but it makes me nervous about, is it gonna be that inconsistent quality throughout? And thus far, I love, love the fourth one. And I can listen to it on my commute to work when I'm walking the dog, so it's really easy for me to get through audiobooks. So I also am gonna go ahead and be like, and the fifth one, I think I'll be able to get through it by the time the end of September rolls around. Maybe in this, even the sixth one, but for, to be safe, I'll stick with the fifth. So that's two of her books right there. Okay, this next one, I way back I included in a book haul, and I've also included on my Instagram to be read post for August, and I do very much plan on reading this after The Blade Itself, and that is These Rebel Waves. And I have been interested in this book forever, and it's just one of those where for whatever reason it's like, oh, but I gotta read this one book before that one, and then I'll get to that one. And then there's this other book, and then there's this other book. But I've always, I see it, and I'm like, I want you. I want to read you. One kind of has like a pirate vibe to it. I actually really love pirates, and I really love pirate-themed stuff. And then it's told from three different perspectives. Like what it says on the back, a revolutionary, a raider, a prince will fight for their countries, their families, themselves, or face a war that could destroy the world as they know it. Sounds dramatic, sounds super YA dramatic. I've been excited for this book for a minute, so I'm like looking forward to rolling over to this one, which will be next. This is one of my books in the book haul, and I mentioned that I don't know what this book is about. I mean, obviously I could just read the inside flaps, but I refuse. I'm going into this book blind. That's just how my relationship with this book has been, and that's how I want it to stay. So, is there werewolves? I don't know. Is there magic? I don't know. Does it take place in France? I weirdly feel like it does, but I don't know why I think that. But I'm looking forward to it. I do want to read it, and now that I own it, I'm like, ooh, and it's one of the thinner ones. I was really wanting to read King of Scars by Leah Bardugo, but that boy is a big book, and I was like, you know what, I could probably squeeze in another book if I went with a thinner one like this guy. And then also in the book haul, Patrick Rothfuss's The Slow Regard of Silent Things. As an author, I don't want to say he's not my favorite. I have an interesting reader-author relationship with him. However, I think this kind of like very, very, I mean, it's less than 200 pages. I think it's barely over 100 pages. This is exactly the kind of thing I was looking for, where I was craving some Rothfuss writing, but I did not, under any circumstances, want to reread Name of the Wind ever again. So this is like, I could not have fallen into better hands, honestly. Okay, and then kind of a random one, but a self-published author sent me their book, and it is called, and I'll throw it up on the screen, The Many Adventures of Peter and Fee. And I am reading this right now too. I'll probably do a review about it, and also maybe a little thing with the author, if they're willing. Thought I'd mention that because I am in fact reading that as well. It's just, I've mostly been doing it off my phone, which has been interesting. I generally, like I said, I've been listening to Audible or reading actual books. I haven't really read something like off a phone or off a tablet in a long, long while. And it's not my favorite, but it has been a really, really fun book thus far. Definitely right up my alley. Has that like fantasy adventure YA vibe to it. So I am excited to talk about that with you guys more in the future. Okay, well, I might as well mention this. My power went out before I started filming, so that's why if things seem a little dim or dark, I have no light. Those things, battery operated. Nature's helping me out with the sunlight, but you know, it's just one of those days. Yeah, so that is my TBR for August and September. Maybe one day I'll be able to read 8 or 9 books in 1 month. I hope to work up to that point, but for now, if I legitimately get through all of these books within that like 2 months, month and a half period, I will be so ridiculously proud of myself. Thank you guys for watching. Leave a comment below if you have read any of this stuff before and your thoughts or feelings about it without giving away any spoilers. And make sure to like this video, share with friends, and to subscribe. That helps me out the most. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.